So in this session, we are going to discuss about what is control modules. So just take an example of, let's say you want to schedule jobs related to SAP BO, or let's say you want to schedule jobs related to Informatica, or let's say you want to schedule jobs which is related to Hadoop. Okay, so all of these applications are third-party applications, and BMC by default doesn't have, you know, functionality to integrate directly with these applications. Okay, so that's why what BMC has done is they have developed control modules. So control modules, you can call it, is it is a kind of plugin which is going to be enabling Control-M to connect to these different applications. Okay, so as we now know that all these Control-M users are going to be connecting to Control-M EM client, and then it is going to be communicated to EM server, and EM server will be communicating to Control-M server. And let's say if it is a OS kind of script which you are scheduling, or it is a batch script or shell script, in that case Control-M server is going to be directly communicating to the agent which is running on those servers, and it is going to be, you know, interacting to process the request of job execution or management or things like that. However, let's say if you want to execute a job which is running on Informatica. Okay, so in that case you need to have control modules for Informatica. Okay, and that is the place where you do all the settings, okay, connection related settings for connecting to Informatica. So for example, when you install control modules for Informatica, in that case you can go to Control-M configuration manager, and there you are going to set up all the, you know, connection string with respect to Informatica. For example, you are going to define what is the URL going to be for Informatica. You are going to define the username, password, which is required to be logged into Informatica, and things like that. Again, this information is going to be different for each type of control modules, because it is really dependent on the application which you are connecting to. For example, let's say in SAP BO, if you want to schedule some reporting, in that case you may also need to provide the root path of reports, okay, and things like that. So this control module is different for each of these third-party application. So I guess there are around some 10-15 majorly used control modules, okay, which is used very frequently, such as control modules for file transfer, control modules for SAP BO, for Informatica, and recently control module for Hadoop is also gaining popularity. Okay, so these are the control modules which is going to be helping you to process the request of scheduling your jobs on these applications. Okay, now in this case you do not need to install Control-M agent on this machine. So for example, let's say if I want to schedule a job using Control-M module for file transfer, and that file transfer is going to be happening on let's say this server. Okay, in that case I don't really need to install Control-M agent on this machine. Okay, so all I'm going to do is we are going to use Control-M file transfer control module. Okay, and that control module is going to be installed on this system. Okay, now whenever you want to install any control modules, there is a prerequisite to have one Control-M agent running on that machine. Okay, so on this machine we also need to make sure that we have Control-M agent running. Now once you have Control-M agent running, you can install all control modules on this system. Okay, so again it is your design call whether you want to keep all the control modules on a single system, or whether you want to install multiple systems and you want to keep some of the control modules on one system and some of the control modules on another system. But the prerequisite is going to be the same. As long as you have a Control-M agent, then you'll be able to install control modules on that system. Now one more important thing to remember here is whenever your Control-M agent is going down, so let's say on this system, okay, on this system you have installed Control-M agent, and let's say if it goes down, okay, if it goes down, in that case all the control modules which are running on top of that Control-M agent is also going to go down. Okay, so that is a kind of dependency which is there on Control-M agent for all of these control modules. Okay, so most of the time this question gets asked in interview as well, because interviewer kind of just want to understand your knowledge about control M. So in that case, they'll be asking what is or where you are going to troubleshoot in case control module is disabled or not available. Okay, so just remember, if control module is not available, you do not need to troubleshoot here, because control module really doesn't have any control, or it is not related to control M server. So all you need to do is, I mean, your first point should be, you should always be checking on the server where you have installed control modules, and that is going to be one of the server where you have control M agent. So in most of the scenarios, there may be chances that control M agent is not able to, you know, interact with control M server, and that's why basically this control M agent is showing as down, and that's the reason all the control modules are also resulting in showing as in down state. Okay, now one more thing is that you don't really need to have an additional server, okay, additional server where you are going to install control M agent and control modules. You can in fact install a control M agent on the same machine, okay, where you have control M server, and in that case you can also install all the control modules here on the same machine. Okay, so it really depends on your design call. If you have more number of servers available and you really want to separate all of these control modules on a different system, in that case you can keep a separate system where you are going to install control M agent along with control modules. The advantage in this case is going to be, let's say if this node is down, or let's say if there is some maintenance activity going on these set of nodes, okay, in that case you don't really need to worry about your control modules going down and all. Okay, and again, let's say for example you have some problem with this server, okay, in that case you are just going to be, you know, doing maintenance activity on this server and your control M server is not going to go down. So that's some of the benefit of separating these control M agent and modules on a different system. Now from the interaction point of view, I hope the point is very clear that whenever you are going to execute any third party related application which is for which control M requires a control module, in that case communication is going to be like this. So this user is going to make a request, and it is going to be then reaching to control M client, to control M EM server, then it is going to reach to control M server, and then it is going to request to control M agent running on this machine. Okay, so this request is going to go to this server where control M agent is running, and then control M agent is going to be discussing or interacting with one of the control modules to process the request. So it can either process the request by connecting to control M Informatica if it is Informatica type of jobs, or it can connect to a control module for SAP BO in case you want to execute SAP BO kind of job. Okay, so hope control module is now clear. If you still have any queries, feel free to ask in Q&A section.